Morning, guys. It's 5:30 in the morning. Got the old Kawasaki 450 loaded up. I'll give you the quick version here in just a sec. Let me get on the road. But we're headed out to Texas. We coming to Texas. If you ever watched the Hodge Twins, you know what that line's referring to. It's still dark as the sun out here. Anyway, buddy of mine, turn the light on just so you can kind of see. Buddy of mine from Texas, when I used to work in the oil refineries out in Texas, my last job I did was at Chevron Refinery in Baytown. And met a guy, a cool guy, about my age. He rides dirt bikes. And I told him I'd come out there and ride with him one day. Well, it's been 5 years after that job. It's the last job I did. I came back, got out of welding, got a different career. But anyway, not too long ago, he hit me up. And, man, I can't see nothing. He hit me up. He's like, hey, man, we're finna have a baby. We're going on our last camping trip for who knows when, because the baby is coming. And see if I want to come out and ride. And I was thinking, hey, it's been 5 years. I never went and rode with him, so heck yeah, I'll come out. It's about a 12 and a half hour drive, not counting stops. So we got a long, long haul ahead of us. It's dark, so you can't see nothing anyway. We cut this camera off. I just want to give you the rundown. It's time to get a bag of ice for the road, keep my drinks cool. Y'all know that feeling you get when you slam a bag of ice. But anyway. One thing I forgot to mention. Ooh, I'm gonna have to throw a couple things back out of here.
It's you. It's always you. If I'm ever gonna fall in love,
just get loose, baby.
No, it's gonna be you. It's you.
I'm gonna tell y'all something. Golly, these roads in Mississippi are terrible. I feel like I'm on a pogo stick in this truck. Jeez.
But a lot of people, but nobody feels like you. So please don't break my heart. Don't tear me apart. I know how it starts. Trust me, I've been broken before.
Burger, some people say.
If you don't think that we're right for each other, then please don't let history repeat itself. Cause I want you.
I didn't video when we got here because it was pretty late. I ended up stopping in College Station, eating at a cool pizza joint. I think it's called Hoobaloo's or something like that. Well, they serve different stuff, but on Friday they serve pizza. It's really cool. So if y'all in College Station, check it out. My boy John helped me get my tent set up last night. The people behind me over there are some relatives to the neighbors. And his neighbors are right here in this tent trailer set up here. And then my boy John, he's in the RV. His wife's pregnant, like really pregnant. So they borrowed his dad's RV to come out. So anyway, we'll let that get charged up, let everybody get stirring. I was the first one up, so I gotta get going this morning. Then we're gonna ride. I think we're gonna run up here to the Bucky's. Go out that way, back to the highway. Somewhere there's a Bucky's close by. So, man, that windshield is dirty. Anyway, there's a Bucky's up there we're gonna go to. I might grab some breakfast and a blanket, because somehow I forgot my blanket had it folded up on the couch, but I have my two sheets. And it got kind of cold last night. I was wrapped up like a burrito in that thing trying to stay warm. So I got to get a blanket too. But anyway, I'll catch up with y'all later. Bucky's, bro.
couldn't get my foot down. It was too far. Well, I just happened to be right on that ditch.
Off the side of this mud.
And the home dude jumped down there. We didn't even know we were talking, looking around. We turn back, get like halfway down. We look back. Where the fuck is Jay go? We walk back. He peeked his head up. Oh my god.
I got down heart. There and graffitied on it.
I had a heart attack. I was like, Jack, what the fuck?
Yeah, bro, imagine how pissed his dad would have been when he come back. So what happened was, yeah, he kind of fell off the side of the porch with me. Yeah, bro. Somebody don't know how to spell loaded.
What?
Eric for what?
Foreman. Eric Foreman!
Oh off of.
No, that's the 70s.
I mean, not King of the Hill, 70s show. That's what I'm at, yeah. Some random dude just down jogging through the woods. Like a damn gazelle, bro. Look at him.
Look as high to Jackie instead of Kelsey and Jackie. I guess that's three different.
You can't go anywhere without seeing a dick painted on it. Like a porta can wall.
Yeah. Live, laugh, love.
I had to fall to lose it all. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. I tried so hard and got so far.
You're like 95% of the video that I'm riding.
It doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all. Oh.
truck, headed out. That's my buddy's dad in front of us with the RV, and him up there in his truck. Kind of had a change of plans, ended up leaving early. I think I'm going to go, they live just south of Houston, so I think I'll follow them back to their house. I'm going to crash there for the night, and then get up and head out early in the morning, because if I left now, it'd be like after 2 or 3 in the morning when I got home, so just going to try to get a fresh start tomorrow. So Bucky's is always super packed, but I'm convinced it's the best gas station to ever exist, except for the fact they have biodiesel, they don't have regular diesel. Falcon. Hold up. And the dice.
It's an electro.
That's about it, then. King's Barbecue in the Falcon.
That's looking. I wish I had the hearse.
He was like, let me see it. And I was like, that's got it.
Can't get enough, only one that I get more time. Cause I got eyes for ya. Might make an exception for ya. Cause I've been feeling ya. Think I might be out of my mind. I think that you're the one.
My last made me feel like I would never try again. But when I saw you, I felt something I never felt. Come closer, I'll give you all my love. If you treat me right, baby, I'll give you everything. My last made me feel like I would never try again. But when I saw you, I felt something I never felt. Come closer, I'll give you all my love. If you treat me right, baby, I'll give you everything.
So it's 5:30 in the morning at my buddy John's house. Got everything ready to go. There's a storm brewing off in the distance. There's a lot of lightning popping off everywhere. Of course, it won't do anything when I actually point the camera at it. So it looks like we're gonna be driving through the rain.
Little bit of stinging rain and big old fat rain. Rain that flew in sideways. And sometimes rain even seemed to come straight up from underneath.
Fixing to get going. I'm gonna ride by a couple places like where I used to stay, kind of on my way out. But then we'll be headed to the house, trucking 10 hours. So this is an Exxon I used to stop at and get gas whenever I was staying over here. I'm fishing the ride by. I come up. I was going to hit. I used to stay on West. When I first come out here, I stayed in a value place on West Fairmont Parkway around in La Porte for like 3 months. I had like a kitchenette, like a small deal. But since I left out for my buddies, it's dark, raining, with all the traffic, I didn't go off and stop. If it had been daylight or just not as much rain and traffic, I'd have went. But just to ride by and see, you know, if it's changed much. But anyway, so I come on across Fred Hartman Bridge to Baytown, and where I-10 is, there's this little Exxon where I used to fill up. I'm fishing to fill up now, because half a tank, fill up, grab a snack or something before I hit the road. So back over there, or down 146, there's a little place I used to eat. I just rode by. And then down that way over there, there's a McDonald's and stuff I used to come to, just something quick. So anyway, the only other thing before I leave, there's a couple other places I was gonna see. Like this little place called Bob and Jean's. It's a little bar, which I don't really drink, but I used to go play pool because it's a cool little place. They got a jukebox, you know, play some pool, whatever. I was gonna ride by there, but since it's dark, because I stayed with my buddy in League City, it's dark when I left and everything, and raining, so I didn't go by. The only other thing, and this is on my way out, I'm gonna hit the U-turn here under this overpass and go and get on I-10, and I'll go by the RV park I used to stay at a lot, and so y'all get to see that when I ride by. It's a nice place, like gated, little gated park, or gated RV park called the Houston East RV Resort. So anyway, I'm finna fill up real quick and see what diesel is here. 319s. Anyway, I'm finna fill up and ride that way. Then I'll be, that's pretty much it. That's my last little scenic route on the way home. I forgot my buddy, he had some, I like click car tags and stuff, and he had a couple of Texas tags he let me get. I had some Alabama tags, like that one right there. I swapped him one out, and he gave me those. But no engine lights. There we go. Anyway, the little restaurant over here I used to eat, it was like a Taco Bell and KFC together. I mean, it was pretty cool because I like Taco Bell, but you can also get something else, like there's some chicken in there. But let's see. The hop over here in the U-turn. That's one thing I love about Texas, man. These red lights, they got U-turns right here. You don't have to go through the intersection, take a left, and stop and go left at that intersection. You just hop over in the U-turn. I wish Alabama had that. You know, there's a lot of other little places I used to go to every now and then, but like it's been so long, I don't remember where all of them are even at. And I didn't really want to look it up on GPS just to go ride by, way out of the way, and check some of them out. So I'm just hitting some of the main, you know, some of the main places. I don't really have video of all of them, like I said, because of all the rain and the traffic. So I didn't go by all of them. But this one here, it's on my way out of town. It's right here on the frontage road. And I stayed there all the time when I had my travel trailer. So I'm gonna ride by there just to see if it's changed any too. Cause it's like I said, it's been 5 or 6 years since I've really been through here. So all right, so here's the place here. Houston East RV Resort. What it's called. It hasn't even changed from the outside anyway. Little pool. It's a little front, like A-frame office. Had a laundry room in the back. Propane, the gate, which is open. I guess somebody went in a few seconds ago. All armor. I got like the office alarm. Anyway, the little tank there is painted with the Texas flag. That's pretty cool anyway. See if I can back up. You know what? Screw it. We'll just cruise through. A lot of these first lots, they're like nightly spots. And the next ones are weekly lots, and then you had the monthly lots, which I stayed in. All those over there, little cabins here. It's so dark, man. I wish it was daylight. I could show y'all all this better. But anyway, I used to stay like that one right there. I stayed a couple places. I stayed at that spot for a while, and then I had a spot down here for a while. But anyway, it's a nice place. It's all good. The laundry room's in the back right there. They got a little basketball court too. Right there. So if you can see it, it's too dark. See, that's the thing, but it's right there. So anyway, it's kind of cool just to see an old place. It ain't changed much. That's really, I was just wondering if anything that made any changes. But anyway, half of the stuff I didn't get to ride by, and the other stuff is dark and random, can't see, but it's cool. I got to see it anyway. Y'all just don't get to see it. But anyway, so I'm finna hit I-10 from Frontage Road. Oh, there's also a drag strip around here somewhere I used to go to, but that's like out of the way. But so I'm fixing to hit I-10 straight to Alabama. Then I gotta hit interstate north, go through Montgomery and all that to go home. So maybe there's one other stop in like Baton Rouge. I may just stop and swing by there. It's a place I used to go to, just kind of on my way through. But I forgot, across from I-10 there where my RV park was, there's also a little Mexican restaurant called Iguana Joe's. It's a pretty cool little place. Man, leaving out at 5:30 reminds me of back when I was working in the plants out here. I'd get up at 5:30 because usually either I'd be at work at 7, work 7 to 5:30, or we'd do 7 to 7 if we're working 12, but brings back memories, man. I don't know if they got a wreck or what, but I-10 stop and go traffic, and I ain't even made it to Beaumont, hardly. Terrible, terrible. This is right here, this guardrail here, right next to my truck, and like this 18-wheeler right here. One time before, when I was hauling my travel trailer, there's also another guardrail on the other side, so the truck couldn't get over. Man, it's like threading a needle trying to drive that travel trailer, which is wider than my truck, through like the guardrail and this joker here. I was drawed up, dude. Yeah, they had a wreck. break on this bridge, I would hate to have to come through here. You know how backed up this mess would be? Golly.
1 hour later.
Oh, finally made it off the bridge. Some fuel and take a leak, get back on the road, take a quick pit stop. I see you, bro. Old Chevy. Got one of these gas station chicken sandwiches. Smells pretty good anyway. But yo, I'm tired of these diesel prices. Look at that. Oh, for the Focus N. Yeah, look at that. Dang Joe Biden and his pipeline policy. Trying to get the water tower at Biloxi. Anyway, that spicy chicken sandwich from Circle K was all right. It ain't no Popeyes or no Chick-fil-A, but it'll fill a hollow spot anyway. So, got about, shut up. Seatbelt. Anyway, then we got about 300 more miles to go. Back in Sweet Home, Alabama. Going around Mobile now, headed north to Montgomery. Speaking of Alabama, y'all gotta do better. What's up with this A&M game? I got a friend of mine, lives in College Station, actually works for the college, A&M fan, of course. Anyway, around this this time of year, we're always talking some smack about the game. Or usually I'm talking more smack just because I like a little healthy competition, you know, and just goofing off. But anyway, and I went right through College Station on the way to Bastrop. I guess I gave them some bad juju or something because they didn't do too good. So anyway, they got to do better next game.
So far away, man. I'd love to go ride more.
my boy John, man, he's just a good dude to hang out with, but hopefully it won't be 5 years before the next time I get to go out there. So anyway, gotta get back, get everything unloaded, put up. So hope y'all enjoyed the ride along.